Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hello lovely Dreamweaver people, in this tutorial we're going to transform these ugly bullet point navigation buttons into these good looking red and green ones. Ignore the font's still ugly, but we'll do that in the following video. But let's do the buttons now. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is get rid of these ugly bullet points. Okay, we do that by styling this thing here. What thing are we styling? We're going to style the ally, which is in the UL, which is in my desktop view. So let's go and do that in our CSS designer panel. Do it in my styles.css. I'd like this to appear globally, and let's click on selectors. Now, because I had this thing selected, it's kind of pre-filled bits of it in, and that's kind of what I want. But if I go, remember up and down makes it more specific. I said I wouldn't say specificity anymore, but there you go. So down means I get more specific, up gets less specific. What I'd like to do, because if I left it there and said I just want to style the allies inside ULs, that would apply across the whole website anytime there's an unordered list. And I might have bullet points just in the normal body copy. So what I want to say is I want, using the down arrow on my keyboard, and to say I want the allies that appear inside ULs that appear inside this class called desktop view. Do I need this A tag here? I do not. Okay, why? Because I'm just playing around with the allies, not worrying about the A tag. It's the ally that gives it the bullet point. Click return. So that's my first style, and I'd like to say under text, I'd like to go down and try and find text decoration. I'd like to find list style type. Undefined, I want to set it to none. Okay, and you see the dots disappeared. Great, and we're just going to slowly work through styling different what's called compound selectors. Okay, so remember selectors, we've dealt with classes before, I have the dots in front of them. And these ones are called compound because they are bits. There's a bit of class there, and there's bits of these regular tags here. Okay, so the compound, bits of everything kind of compounded together. You don't need to remember the word compounded. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is I'd like to, at the moment these are stacked on top of each other. Okay, this is their default state for allies, and that stack on top of each other is called block. Okay, so by default these are in a display called block, which means they stack on top of each other. We want to change that. We would like to go up the top here, okay, to layout, and we'd like to find display. And instead of block, we're going to pick inline block, and that stacks them side by side. Easy. Now, if we were styling these all the same color, I could go into my background color and change the background color. My problem is that I want them to be different. So let's check out my Illustrator file. You can see in Illustrator, I want them to be two different colors. So if I style the ally, it means that they're both going to become red or green. And that's not what I want. I want them to be different colors. So let's jump back into Dreamweaver. Let's create two classes. We'll create one called red button and green button and apply them to them. The reason we're doing that is that we can reuse that green button or red button because there are going to be other buttons on our site that we're going to use this for. So down here, doesn't matter what you've got selected, but it's going to go into styles.css, global, and then selectors, I'm going to click plus. Forget what's in there, we're going to create our own class. I'm going to call it BTN, okay, then hyphen, and we're going to call the first one red. Why do we call it BTN red and not red BTN? It just means that they're going to be stacked next to each other in the CSS here. Button green, button red, we could have a button blue, and it's just easier to find them that way. So click on button red, and I'm going to go to background, and I'm going to pick a color. Now, if you've done my Illustrator course, you would have known how to export the CSS. We're going to quickly look at this now. So in Illustrator here, I'm going to click on this background here. I'm going to go to window. We're going to go to CSS. Where are you? CSS properties. And it's going to tell me what the background color is. And that's the thing here I want. I'm going to double click it, right click it, click copy. And if you did do the Illustrator course, you might have exported this as a text document. But because we are both the designer and the front end web developer, we are going to just copy and paste straight from the Illustrator file. So I've copied it, jump back into Dreamweaver. And in here, I'm going to click on background color, and we're going to go back to our hexadecimal numbers. You can see in Illustrator, there was actually both options. Okay, I just find these easier just because they're simpler codes to copy and paste. Okay, so in background color here, we're going to go back to hex, and we've got to make sure that we've got the hash in front of it. I didn't copy that from Illustrator. Hit return. Okay, and that's my little background color. Now I'm going to apply it. So what do we apply it to? Do we apply it to the A tag? I don't think it matters. We probably run into problems later on. Let's hope we don't. So we're gonna go into here, go BTN, and there it is there, red, lovely. And it's got a background color of red. Not the padding we need, but we'll do that in a sec. So we'll do this guy next. So we'll create a new selector. Everything's selected correctly. We'll call this one dot BTN. We'll call this one green. Same thing. We're gonna jump into Illustrator. Here in Illustrator, I'm gonna click on this guy, grab that guy, copy. For some reason, I can't do Command C for copy or Control C on a PC. I don't know why. Okay, you might be able to. But in here, I'm gonna go this one. I'm gonna go to my hexadecimal numbers, leave the hash in there. That's my green. I'm gonna apply it to this one. Here we go, dot BTN. Oh, BTN. That's the other reason we call it BTN, because they're all grouped there when we type in B. Lovely. Okay, so now we want to add some padding to the top and bottom of these buttons. This is where it's a bit of trial and error. I promise you, I didn't know off by heart. I just kind of tried both options of styling both this one here, because you're like, oh, I can just style the ally, okay, and add some padding to this. And I did it, and I went, that didn't work. So we had to go for a different method. So let's go for the broken method, okay, always a great one to start with. So I've got these allies that are inside of my ULs, which are specifically inside my desktop view, which is great. They're really specific. And I'm gonna say I'd like some padding. I'm gonna drag it up, okay? And you can see it's not really adding padding, it's just pushing it from the top. So that's when I went, not that. See this trash can here? Turn that off. So what I decided was, is I clicked on this guy and I went new style and I'm gonna make it more specific. Okay, so I press my down arrow. So it needs to be the desktop view, allies. And what I needed to do is this A tag. Okay, so that's down the bottom here. You can see there's an A tag inside an ally, inside a UL. Now, I leave this in here as well because I'd love to just tell you the answer, but trust me, there's things where you think, definitely, I'm 100% sure that's gonna work, and then it doesn't. And you're like, You have to kind of look at the tags and go, okay, what else could I try? So in our case, the active link, okay, the hyperlink, which is inside the ally, which is inside the UL, which is inside desktop view, this one's gonna work. Wow. I hope it's gonna work. And I'm gonna go to the top one, layout. I'm gonna add some padding to this. I'm gonna just drag it up. There you go, so that one's working. And what is it? It is 13 at the top and bottom, 13, and it is 43 at the left and right. 43, again, my keyboard seems to be typing in double fours. 13 at the bottom, and 43 on that side. You can see, those are all my little buttons working. Awesome. Okay, next thing I want to do is I need to kind of like move that up a little bit, and you can use minuses. You're like, cool, so we did the padding on this one, we'll just use minus margins, and it doesn't work. Okay, hit the trash can. So it's a bit weird sometimes trying to like work out, is it the A tag inside the LI, which is inside the UL? And if you get frustrated, don't worry. It's a general frustration all industry around. So maybe I can do it to this one. Okay, the LI UL. I go minus in here, and that doesn't work either. Okay, and so I work out that I need to go it to the actual desktop view. So let's go selector. There's one I've already got, it's called desktop view. And if I do it to this one, you can see it starts working. I'm gonna click and drag because I wasn't sure about there. Wow, cool. When I close for that one, and so -5 pixels, it goes up. So sometimes you're like, okay, is it this one? Is it this one? Why is it not? And you end up having to create a lot of classes and delete them just to figure out which one's controlling it. All right, we're gonna do a save all. Next thing I wanna do is remove the underlines, okay? So the underlines are controlled by, you can play around with all of these, but it's actually the A tag, because that's specific for hyperlinks, okay? So we're gonna go to that one, gonna go to type, and we're gonna go down here to text decoration and pick none. Okay, by default, it's on underline. Cool, so that's gone. Let's do the font color. It's probably gonna be the same one, hopefully. And the font color comes from Illustrator. Okay, I'm gonna click on this text here, and there it is. There's the font and the color. I'm gonna right click it, click copy, back into Dreamweaver. Okay, and nope, back into Dreamweaver. And we're gonna go font color, hash, leave that there. And it's kind of like just an off-white. All right, the next thing I wanna do to make these buttons work is I wanna play with the font. At the moment, the Times New Roman, which is not gonna work for me. So I wanted to look at using fonts, something a bit different from Arial and Times New Roman and the built-in fonts. So we're gonna look at that in the separate tutorial, which is right after this one.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.